I made this shot with AI, and I think that the quality speaks for itself. Nano Banana handled the frozen look, and Mago retextured the video with the top AI quality. It's quite easy to use, surprisingly powerful, and kind of addictive once you see what this combo can do. So let me show you exactly how I did that.
So this is the product that we will use, and I will prepare it in Photoshop in combination with Nano Banana because it's in it and it's pretty cool. What I need to do first is to put this bottle somewhere in the bottom. So let's select everything in here and let's hit Generative Fill. Let's choose Gemini 3 and now put this bottle on the countertop in the I'm not looking for any specific bathroom, so I will go with this and we will see. I will decide then. And this one looks pretty cool. Let's maybe generate one or two shots. I would probably prefer bottle to remain somewhere in the center of the frame. Keep the product center, rotate it naturally and generate. But already this first one is kind of cool, and also text is readable, and this is much better. I like this composition really well, but I actually preferred something like this as a bathroom. This is too sterile. I would maybe add cozy. I think this word might solve the problem. Cozy bathroom that generate. But while this is being generated, this is pretty cool. This is much better. But I don't like those tiles in the background. Let's try cozy premium. I don't like how the product is blended in. I will just let it run one more time. Oh, this is cool, but it's not. It actually is bathroom, but I almost thought it's a kitchen. Never mind. Let's do it one more time. This is it. But for sure, you can see the text is not readable. And I can probably let it do again, but we are in Photoshop. Why not to fix it manually? So I will do it right now. And done. It was kind of fast, and why even to push it in AI if you could easily do it right in Photoshop? I'm happy with it. This is fine. So we have basically our main image, which I will export file, export PNG. And now what I will do is I will select all, let's hit generative fill. And now with Nano Banana, the pro version, I will prompt it to make it covered with ice or sear gets frozen and generate. My idea basically is to create a clip where this product is placed on the countertop and whole scene starts to freeze, which might look kind of cool. And as you can see with this image, it really does. I'm basically completely fine with it. I will just pick one of maybe two or three generation just to find that one which I like the most. This is the one. I actually don't need to do any more, but let's do one more. However, if this one won't get better, I will definitely continue with this one. This is perfect. So I will export this one just as well. And now you could probably use those two images as first and last frame and let the AI create that freezing transition. But if you would like to introduce in it some motion of a camera, well, I don't think it would work, because this is static shot basically, just to interpolate it between two frames that have basically same framing, only it's frozen here. So yeah, there is some inner motion in it, but camera doesn't move. And if you would prompt it to create you a different like view on this very scene, it could do that, but it always introduces some different elements. And even with those small differences, such motion might get tricky. Therefore, I will adopt my approach, which is creating video from normal image and then get it retextured with Mago to be eyes image. And with these two videos, I can then play in After Effects, because in there I have way more control to somehow push it even better. So first thing we need is video. It really doesn't matter where you will do it. I will do mine in Hicksfield. So let's create a video and I will pick start frame and battle normal. And in here, I think that new clink might work just fine. I will use general setting and product backshot clip. Camera zooms out and orbits little bit. I think that's fine. And I don't need audio. 5 seconds should be okay. And we can generate. And while this is being generated, I can also try seed end, because it is also one of my favorites. 5 seconds is just enough. Let's hit generate. And we could also try video 3.1, because why not? Frames. No, it's just the first frame. Then it could be, I don't need 8 seconds. 6 are just fine. Now we only need to wait. And now we have another badge. This is much better. I think this last winner is still kind of clear all the time. Yeah, we will use it. Let's hit download. And now the fun begins, because in order to let it retexture with our frozen scene, you need to have quite a good video-to-video model. And for that, I am using Mago Studio. It's one of the best video-to-video models, because you have way more settings you can tweak than just, for example, use Luma Modify or, I don't know, Runway Aleph. Those two are sometimes hit or miss, but in here, you can get a certain level of control. So let's create a new project. And in here, we can upload our video, which is this clip. I don't need to trim it. And even if you do not trim it from the beginning, because there is the first frame which you actually really need, because you have already a new version of it. Otherwise, it wouldn't work. Let's trim and upload. You can see that we have 140 frames to be retextured. And for that, we basically need that first frame, which we already have, but you can have it stylized here. I, however, have mine prepared, which is this one. And the layout of the first frame matches the first frame of this clip. In here, it created a prompt, which is most of the time just fine. I don't need to change anything. But we are not ending here, because here we provided it image reference and text reference. There is also a negative prompt, which I rarely change. Most of the time I'm keeping it as it is. But in here we have two more tabs. One is control nuts. Here you can pick what you want the model to use to like analyze the scene. Of course you don't need pose and pose and depth because it's no character in here. And the safe version here would be probably depth. So I'm going to use depth. With it, here you can set up the resolution which you want to use. Of course, if you want to save some credits or get it generated probably faster, you can get lower pixels, just rewrite it here. But I will stick with the best version available. Then you have two other parameters. Face mesh is irrelevant for now because we don't have face here. And strength basically tells it how closely it should stick to the original video in case of motion and action within the scene. I will leave it as it is. And then we will move to advanced, where we can pick which model to use. And I'm quite optimistic to go and try beta 3.4. Quality settings, output file size 1280. Then you can set up steps here. The higher you get this value, the more it costs. However, the video will be better. You can, for example, try interpolation, which only renders every other frame and interpolates in between, which will save some credits. Then CFG, which is prompt influence. Think about it this way. You always have two inputs there. You have image input and text input. And it tries to like balance those. However, I want it to be more focused on image. So I will make this value lower so it sticks more to the image, not so much to the text. Then color consistency seed shift. I don't think I need to change anything in here. Just take a look at steps and CFG. Nothing more. The higher the steps, better the quality, and the lower the CFG number is, the less importance has the text input. And with these settings ready, you can hit generate or test. Because honestly, you never know how it will turn out. Therefore, you can get the quicker video, which only generates first 48 frames in here. But I'm feeling lucky, so I will let it generate whole clip. And let's hit click. I can send it right now. And you can see we have new row here, which will have this clip retexture with our first frame. And you can have more of these rows here. If you would like to test multiple reference frames, you can do it here. Let it run simultaneously and then get back once this is done. In here you can see it will take up to 20 minutes because my original video is full HD and I wanted it to be the best quality I can get here with higher step number. So yeah, it takes time. And now the video is done. You can take a look. It's pretty impressive, I must say. And from now on, the heavy lifting is basically done because now only thing I need to do is download this video. And also, what is cool here is that you have also a depth video here. And you can use this video to mask in After Effects, which we will definitely use. So I will download this one also, and let's move to After Effects. And in here, after some layering, masking and stuff like that, I ended up with something like this, where you can see that the eyes is slowly spreading. I also introduced some turbulent displays, so the edges are not to uniform, otherwise it won't look good. In here I can see that it's like an arc, which I will probably fix because I don't like it right now. And if we do some color grading with it and add some sound design, it could look like this.